So did we dance or didn't we?
We must have done. We can meet in our dreams. Rita?
Henry Mallet, I hope you've forgiven us.
For what?
I just wondered if you wanted to...
Oh, look, I'd love to help you out, but I just can't tonight.
Hi, Susie.
Terry's here for his checkup.
Oh, hi, Terry.
You did you?
No. No!
You'll be back.
In your dreams, Steve.
I just can't be with a ghost.
How is that ever gonna work?
Stupid.
I'm sorry, honey, but I have to go. Okay, you know I have to go. I can't just sit around here and simmer because you feel like you might need someone around. This is important to me. Would you just stop it? It's just emotional blackmail. Please, I mean it. Fine. This is the way it's going to be. I am very sorry, honey. I really am. But there is nothing more that I can do.
Hey, look, I've noticed something. This place, all around here, and into the waiting room, and beyond into the room with the pneumatic chair, it's a place filled with fear.
Yeah, it's always interested me. That patient's fear of going to the dentist. It's completely unfounded, given contemporary practices. Oh, morning, Linda.
Hi. You're talking to yourself.
Oops. Thank you.
Though I stand in the pool of fear, I'm not afraid.
Oh, that's lovely. I don't know what a ghost would be afraid of.
What are you afraid of?
Oh, I know how to handle my fear.
Oh, really? Do tell, Dr. Darling.
Thought you'd never ask.
Something brewing in the air, Suze. I can feel it.
Try doing a few cartwheels.
Yeah, I'll bear that in mind.
Well, it's perfect for my needs, Don, because my needs are simple. Sign here.
And just your initials on the bottom of all pages.
And the duplicate as well?
Ta. Will your wife be joining you?
Sorry? Oh. No. Separated.
Me too. So is Roger over in 3 and Dom in 6. We play 500 occasionally. Do you play?
Sorry, bud. Not old enough to play cards.
Hot water system takes 20-cent pieces, change available from the office. If you're going to clean fish, do it down the boat ramp and not near the barbecue.
Fantastic. Love it. Oh, how long do you get for your 20 cents?
2 minutes. Not bad.
Seriously? Can I have one?
Fire, you bastard! Lights!
Don't forget to pick up the dry cleaning.
Of course.
How are you going to do?
Haven't decided. Just make sure you get the red one.
Do you want some blueberries?
Yes, thanks.
Ah, Steve. What a lovely fish.
I thought you'd appreciate the gesture. That is fresh out of the sea.
Oh, poof. What's that pong?
That, my dear, is a freshly caught snapper.
Mm.
Elvis, come here and see what I've done. I have caught a fish. But more importantly, who's got a birthday coming up?
Me.
Thought about a party?
He says he can't be bothered organising one.
Well, I'll do it. Big one for my place. My new place.
Daddy's moved into a caravan.
Great. Why?
That's a good question.
That is a good question. Short answer is, I'm trying to get back to just me, yeah? The essence of Steve Darling.
I'll come to the party.
Great. Grab some of your friends and we'll make a night of it.
Sure.
Tell you what, why don't we go out, grab you a few bits and pieces and we can start planning. I want to break the mould with this one. New kind of party. Like where I'm coming from?
Yeah, that sounds interesting.
Well, what about a hard disk recorder?
Oh, you don't want one of those.
Yes, I do. You asked me what I wanted.
Look, you've got to think more long term. What about the sort of present that gives to others? Now, have you heard of this great program where you can buy a goat for an African village?
No.
So, I donate some money on your behalf and an entire village drinks milk for a year. Now, I'd call that a pretty interesting birthday present, wouldn't you?
I guess.
Look, sometimes you've got to step back and look at the bigger picture. We're a global community. Have you ever milked a goat?
No.
That is something we should have a go at. Give a man a goat, he can eat for a day. Teach a man how to milk that goat, well, he can eat for a year.
Well, drink.
And eat. If he kills the goat after he milks it.
Open and close together. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Can I help you?
Hello.
Well, if you have an appointment, you just wait in the waiting room, please.
My name is Adrian Barnes. I work for Clayton Burgess and Associates. We're investigating the legal matters of a former resident.
Oh, well, I'm sorry. I don't think I can help you. I've only been living here for a short while.
Well, it won't take long. Perhaps there's someone we can go and chat without...
I'm with a patient at the moment. We're almost done here.
Uh-huh. Is this a relative?
That's my father.
Well, maybe I could speak with him.
He's dead.
Right.
Look, maybe I can take you up to see Rocco in Unit 17. He's the caretaker. I'm just going to prepare a fluoride treatment. I'll be back in a tick. He's usually at home.
Hello, Susie.
Hello. Sorry to bother you. This man came into my surgery. He's a lawyer chasing up the personal effects of an ex-resident. I thought you could help him.
Oh, no, dear, dear.
Can you help him?
Yes. Certainly.
Okay. Sorry, it's a pain, but I'll just leave you to it. Okay.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Susie?
You. It's nice.
Tea.
No thanks.
Yes, lovely.
Are you all right?
Yes.
You don't have to do this now. I'm sure he can wait.
I'm sure it won't take long.
Yes, I wonder how you can help me, Mr. Bukowski. I get the feeling you're going to be most informative.
Oh, it's been so long. I thought we'd heard the end of it.
Could I have a glass of water, please?
I don't think you should do this now. We'll make another time. You're not feeling well.
Well, if there is a time that suits you better.
We can do that. It's within our rights. You just sit here and rest. My darling.
I'll be in touch.
We'll be fine. We'll be fine.
Hey, how you doing? Steve Darling speaking. Great. What's he offering? Yeah, right. Listen, Martin, let's lay some ground rules, shall we? You don't call me with offers below 5 mil because I won't be selling that house for anything less than that. Is that clear? Good. Dickhead.
Rocco, darling. Tea's ready. Rocco? Where are you?
I'll tell you later, okay? Can you take your sister upstairs? Thanks, Elvis. So, was it a heart attack or...?
I think so.
Yeah. You know, they were together for over 40 years.
What's going on? That's not me, is it? Is that me? Have they found me down in the basement under some rock?
Oh, Rocco. Rest in peace.
Rocco? Oh, my God.
Button isn't working.
Elvis! Come on, kids. I said, upstairs, please.
What happened, Mum?
Oh, it's Rocco. He got sick.
Did he die?
Unbelievable.
I'm afraid so.
Why did they have to cover him up?
So they didn't freak anybody out.
I think we should go and see Rita. She's probably sad.
Oh, that's a good idea. Yeah, we'll pop down and see her later.
I saw him leave the building. He jumped in a cab and drove away. He was wearing a suit. He had a little suitcase. Go downstairs, and he's being wheeled out in a body bag.
Oh, you're getting your times mixed up. He must have just popped up for some milk.
Why, in a
and
suit?
Then he came back later and died.
No. Rocco died. He was dead. Moments later, a cab pulls up to take him somewhere.
So you think you saw Rocco's ghost?
Yep. And he saw me.
What did he do?
He didn't do anything. Just fucking left. This is brilliant. The old man gets to go straight away and I don't. Why?
Well, Rocco was old. He lived all of his life. Maybe You don't get to leave until you've experienced all of your journey.
Oh, wonderful. Magnificent. Well, so the successful journey is just getting old, is it? Doesn't matter if you waste your existence eating sausages and brushing crumbs off the table. I lived every second of my existence as if it were my last, and if the universe thinks that's wrong, then the universe could go fuck itself.
Steve, here are the bits for the party and those books I was telling you about. Look, Steve, I've made a decision to try and get over you, so I won't be doing any more errands for you or anything else bloody humiliating and stupid, blind man user. Anything else like that. Yeah, that felt good. Yeah, really good. Yes.
Made you a sandwich.
Oh, maybe Rita doesn't feel like a sandwich right now.
It's peanut butter.
Perhaps I'll eat it later.
So should we start with the Thai?
Oh, they said to bring three. That one's nice.
This one?
You must be sad about Rocco.
Yes, very.
Where is he now?
Well, his body's at the funeral parlour waiting for... I want him to look nice. He always did look handsome in a suit.
What about his soul?
Verity?
Alpha said, when you die, your soul goes somewhere else and your body stays here.
His soul? I don't know.
It's gone. To a better place.
I hope so. I just feel, I mean, I get the sense he's here with me.
Well, I mean, we don't know what happens after life, do we? I mean, we could go somewhere else, drive off somewhere else or something along those lines. This one?
My goodness. Rocco wore that the night we met.
What happened?
Oh, was it a party? In a car park, of all places. He was there with his idiot brother, Tony. Tony made a beeline for me. But I knew what I wanted. And when we kissed for the first time, well, that's when a girl knows, doesn't she? When everything makes sense. We dated for about a year before he got up the courage to ask my father to marry.
Henry.
He was beside himself.
Henry, I found this in Rocco's suit pocket. Someone saw a man fall off a ferry, October 15th, 1982. No body was found.
What the?
No one else saw it. Could this be what happened?
Mum, should I ask Rita to come for a swim?
Okay, that's a great idea.
I've just been knocking on the Bukowski's door for 10 minutes.
Well, I'll let Rita know that you dropped by.
Do you mind if I wait here?
Oh, she'll be a while.
Yeah, please.
Who's this weedy bastard?
Look, Rita's husband passed away earlier today, and I don't think she's going to be taking visitors for some time. Oh, dear. Here you are. So much crying today.
That's because dying's sad. See you later.
All right. Don't forget your hat.
Okay.
I'm really sorry about this. It's just come as a bit of a shock, that's all.
Oh, I didn't realise you knew Rocco.
Oh, I didn't. We just met. just that I've been looking for such a long time.
Fee-fi-fo-fum, I smell the blood of an Englishman.
What's he doing here?
I'm sorry, I have no idea what you're talking about.
It's just that the link was so close. I mean, everything led to these apartments. I mean, Mr. Bukowski knew something. I could tell that he knew something.
Knew something about what?
My father may have lived in this building years ago.
Who the hell are you?
Oh, so you're looking for your father?
Yes. I haven't seen him in a very long time. His name is Henry Mallett.
That's not my son. It's not. My son's name's Apollo.
Apollo?
How do you know that name?
Oh, this is bullshit. He's lying. Ask him to prove it.
What, did Mr. Bukowski know something about Henry? Are there any letters lying around that might have mentioned me? I mean, I know that he lived here.
Ask him where he grew up then.
I bet he doesn't even know.
Ask him what his favourite fucking Nerve song is.
Well, even a photo would do.
I'm sorry, this is really, it's freaking me out. I need 5 minutes. Can you just give me 5 minutes? I'm quite the nervy that you are, but still, hi.
Join me.
Ah, yes, of course.
Look a little stressed there. A rough morning.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, I hear that. Listen, about Elvis's party.
Oh, you're going?
Well, he invited me. I hope that's okay.
Oh, it's lovely.
Have you any idea what he might like for a present?
Well, I'm getting him a motorised tyre rack.
Good choice. You sure you're all right?
I just need a coffee. Have a long back, please. Henry Mallett is dead.
R.I.P., man. But his spirit can't die. His music lives on. I mean, here we are. 30 years later, talking about him as if he were right here.
I have to go.
So is this always your response to heavy shit, run away?
Why did Rocco have that article in his suit pocket?
I don't know.
Why has my life been taken over by a ghost?
I wish I could help you with that one.
Oh, where's my cab? Where's my cab? Did it ever occur to you that having a son who you refuse to acknowledge might, just might, constitute unfinished business?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Why didn't you tell me you had a child?
I've never exactly thought of him as my child.
Not good enough. This new cleaner, not good enough. The floor is filthy. Well, how would you like me to deal with this?
Could you make him go away, please?
Henry, we need a plan.
Shit. He hasn't, has he?
Hello?
Listen, Adrian. I know you've been going through a hard time at the moment.
Yeah, it just about covers it.
You do know. You know your dad's probably dead, don't you? I mean, it's more than likely that he passed on a number of years ago. That makes sense to you, right?
Yeah, I always figured that in a way, about him being dead.
Right.
I mean, you follow every stupid internet lead and fan sighting. The whole reason I came out here was because someone put a message on the uncut message board saying that this was the last country Dad was seen in. But what was I expecting, eh? Big happy reunion at the airport. That's the way it usually works. I'm sure Dad was really sorry about giving up all his responsibilities to take off and live the life of a jet-setting playboy. Must have been tough.
Yeah, it was.
Is that really what happened?
No.
Yeah. Mum had me and then Henry got famous. Nappies and grocery lists don't really cut it in the punk rock legend world. So Mum ended up with his best mate, Billy. Henry was just some wild-eyed, crazy uncle type who showed up now and again and stole all our booze. Mum only told me he was my real father on my 18th birthday. By then, he was long gone.
I freaked out.
Right. Is your mum Charlotte?
Yep.
Yeah. How do you know that?
Tell him. Go on. Tell him the thing. I can't bear to watch him suffer any longer.
So, I have a connection to Henry Mallett's spirit.
Really?
Oh, it's true.
Really? It's a psychic gift.
What, you can channel the dead?
Yep.
Just Henry Mallett.
You're having me on.
Why would I?
Well, prove it. Tell me something that only he would know.
Right. Tell him I'm sorry I gave him his first fag.
He is sorry for giving you your first cigarette.
Extended family. These men form part of the band of Elvis's fathers.
No, they just live here. I'm paying them $50 to make the fire. There you go.
Thanks, mate.
Come, everyone. Take a seat. Gather round. Watch the sun go down. This is how Neanderthal man used to celebrate their birthday.
In a caravan park.
Around a fire. Just people coming together, telling stories, passing on history.
Did cavemen even celebrate birthdays?
Of course they did.
How'd they know what day it was?
They marked it on the wall with a stick.
I thought that was prison.
That bit's not important right now. What is important is thinking about the tribes and the way they marked a young man's transition into adulthood. Now, among the samurai, it's called Genpuku. The Setback River tribes, Papua New Guinea, used to celebrate the rite of passage by scarification.
So that's what you're gonna do to me tonight? Burn me with a stick?
Just thought you'd find that interesting.
What are we gonna eat?
Soon. Now, who likes fish?
Do we not have any party pies?
Well, you can catch a party pie with one of these, then good luck to you.
I'm assuming there's a backup meal.
Nope, no catching, no eating.
Hello, everyone.
Hi.
Where's the present table?
Oh, it's over by the goat.
Oh.
Hi.
Hi.
Right. Now, who's ready for some big, big fun?
Oh, my God. Do you want this in here?
No.
We'll be out in a minute.
Thanks, sweetie.
Maybe Fabby.
Like a leg.
Thanks.
Okay. Just Need to concentrate?
Oh, you're not serious. Look at you, you look like a Gypsy Rose Lee.
This is all part of the process.
Have you found him yet?
He's gonna think you're mental. Mm. You're dressed like a big hippie spaz.
All right, Adrian, I'm listening to your father now.
Wow. Wow, can he hear what I'm saying?
Yeah, I'm right here, son. Ooh.
He can hear you, yes.
Right, well, you loved Mum and I, and yet you left. Why didn't you stay around and try and make a family?
Oh, right in. No fucking warm-up. No, how's your day been, Dad? What's it like being dead?
Henry, Adrian needs to hear about your relationship with his mum, with Charlotte.
Oh, Adrian needs to know that, does he? Right. She was a paranoid Fruit Loop, Suze. She thought I was fucking everything in sight. She wanted to put me in a box with a little lock on it.
Okay. Henry, I need you to speak to us tonight.
What's she saying?
Oh, come on, Henry. Speak to me.
You want to know why I didn't hang about? Because the idea of having kids bored the shit out of me. Okay, there it is. I know that's not very cool, but that's the way it was. I just wasn't that into the idea of being a daddy.
What's he saying?
Don't tell him that.
Oh, Henry, I'm losing you.
I was young, Suze. I was a cock. But I'm not that guy anymore. I look at you with your kids and that's not bullshit. It's beautiful.
Oh, oh no.
What is this for?
Bump.
You've got it late.
Now, let me show you.
How nice is the fire?
Pretty nice. Chip?
I don't mean to be nosy, but something's changed in you since the first time we met at Susie's place.
Really?
None of my business.
No, fine. I've done some work on a long-standing personal issue and I've made some radical changes, so...
Well, something's working for you there.
It's hard. Oh, I'm sorry.
Hey,
You carry a handkerchief.
Yeah, I do.
Hey,
on you two. Plenty of gear for everyone.
How about us grown-ups go to the caravan for a glass of wine?
Great idea.
Yeah. Why?
Well, just leave them to it.
Who's going to teach them the proper techniques?
They'll muddle through. It's fine. Come on. Is this better?
Do you know how he died?
I'm not sure.
No, it was a suicide. I'm certain of it.
How?
Well, it fits his character type, doesn't it?
Always wanting to cut out when the going gets rough.
That's bollocks.
I'm not sure that that's right.
I'm sure it is. It's the coward's way.
I was on a ferry in the harbour. I was pissed and I fell and I drowned.
What did he say?
Such a inglorious way to die.
He drowned. He drowned, he fell off a ferry. very sad.
This is amazing.
I'm sorry.
I would like to know, does he have any regrets?
Henry, did you hear that?
Yeah. I got a few regrets. I was a bastard and I got scared and I ran away.
He acknowledges that he made a few mistakes.
And that he hurt a lot of people.
Oh yeah, and I was a prick. Don't forget to mention that. I was a selfish prick.
He says he was a selfish prick. But he didn't know he was gonna die. He didn't get a chance to right his wrongs. He didn't get that chance.
Right. He said that, did he?
No, I did. I think he's a nicer man dead than he was alive.
You have the most beautiful eyes.
Oh. Give me a moment. Henry, what do you want me to do?
I don't know, do I? I didn't plan this far ahead.
He's very upset.
He wanted to kiss you.
Yeah. He must be feeling very vulnerable. It must be very confusing for him.
Susie. He wanted to kiss you. Because you're so fucking gorgeous. And sweet.
Oh, okay. Well, should I go back out there?
You interested in him?
Henry, no.
Well.
Golly. No. No.
They sound like they're really into it.
Yeah. Teenagers are so funny.
Yes. So funny. And weird. More wine?
Thank you.
They're quite cozy, these things, aren't they?
Not bad for one, I suppose.
I don't know, it's a pretty good fit for two.
I wonder, would you call this a breakfast nook or a fold-away table?
Can it be both?
I suppose so.
You are sensational.
Don't talk.
I keep pretending I'm leaving. To try and remember why I can't. So many accusations for so little blame. I'd ask you for your keys, but I feel out of breath. I probably just lose them, so it's all for the best. And time will surely find you, the stranger to your nest. It pays to travel light or running far from this. Thank you.
listened to that song so many times. I had no idea it was about me.
Every line, son. Every line.
Would you like some fish? It's a snapper.
No. Look, I shouldn't have tried to kiss you before.
Seriously, it's fine.
Oh, not really. It's...
Hi, Mum.
Hello, sweetheart. How was Rita?
Good. We watched some cartoons. She laughed twice. And cried once.
Oh. I think you need to resolve the memory of your dad. Just find a way to let the pain go. I know it's hard to hear.
What do you mean? Have I done something wrong?
No, no, sweetheart. Just give me a second. Maybe you could take all the information that you've been given and spend some time with him yourself.
But Dad's at Elvis's party.
Verity, I'm just speaking to our guest, Adrian. Okay?
Mum, who's Adrian?
He's my long-lost son, come to tell me what a shithead I've been.
And to see what a silly old dead fuck you are, Henry.
Oh, is Adrian coming over tonight?
Oh.
You're dead.
Yes, Daddy. I'm dead.
It's the hardest decision a father can make.
He can't stay here.
Susie.
Either he goes or I do.
I'm getting my children out of here.
A disgruntled son, hell-bent on destroying everything they have.
Steve, where are the kids? Henry!
Who is this Henry?
Steve!
A W exclusive, Spirited. Wednesday, 7:30 p.m. Series link it now.
Sunny. Yesterday my life was filled with rain. Sunny, you smiled at me and really eased the pain. Now the dark days are done and the bright days are here. My sunny one shines so sincere. Sunny one so true, I love you. Sunny, thank you for the sunshine bouquet. Sunny, thank you for the love you brought my way. You gave to me your all in all, and now I feel 10 feet tall. Sunny, one so true, I love you. Let me see, Sunny. Thank you for the facts from A to Z. My life was torn like windblown sand. Then a rock was formed.